ओके, चैप्टर नंबर 15 पॉलीमर एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज कोपोलीमराइजेशन। ओके, वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ एडिशन पॉलीमर। वन इज होमोपोलीमर एंड अनदर इज कोपोलीमर। ओके, नाउ द मेन डिफरेंस बिटवीन होमोपोलीमर एंड कोपोलीमर इज इन होमोपोलीमर इट नेम सजेस्ट होमो मीन्स सेम, सो होमोपोलीमर विल बी हैविंग सेम टाइप ऑफ मोनोमर, वेयर एज कोपोलीमर विल हैव टू डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ मोनोमर, सो हियर मोनोमर्स विल बी डिफरेंट। ओके, सो कोपोलीमराइजेशन इज अ पोलीमराइजेशन रिएक्शन इन विच अ मिक्सचर ऑफ मोर देन वन मोनोमर स्पेसिस इज अलाउड टू पोलीमराइज एंड फॉर्म अ कोपोलीमर, विच मीन्स द कोपोलीमर आर हैविंग मोनोमर्स आर ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स। सो होमोपोलीमर्स विल हैव सेम टाइप ऑफ मोनोमर, वेर एज कोपोलीमर विल हैव टू डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ मोनोमर्स। ओके, हियर द सेकेंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इज द कोपोलीमर कैन बी मेड नॉट ओनली बाय चेन ग्रोथ पोलीमराइजेशन बट ऑल्सो बाय स्टेप ग्रोथ पोलीमराइजेशन। सो कोपोलीमराइजेशन कैन बी डन बाय चेन ग्रोथ एंड इट कैन ऑल्सो बी डन बाय स्टेप ग्रोथ पोलीमराइजेशन। सो चेन ग्रोथ एंड स्टेप ग्रोथ पोलीमराइजेशन बोथ आर पॉसिबल इन दिस केस। बेस्ट एग्जाम्पल इज ब्यूना एस एंड द मोनोमर्स ऑफ ब्यूना एस आर 1,3 बीटाडाइन एंड स्टायरीन। ओके, सो हाउ 1,3 बीटाडाइन इज ड्रॉन, सो ब्यूटा मीन्स 4 कार्बन, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू ड्रॉ 4 कार्बन 1, 2, 3, 4, देन 1,3 बीटाडाइन इट मीन्स देयर आर डबल बॉन्ड एट कार्बन नंबर 1 एंड 3, तो यू हैव टू ड्रॉ डबल बॉन्ड एट कार्बन नंबर 1 एंड कार्बन नंबर 3, देन रिमेनिंग वैलेंसी विल बी सेटिस्फाइड बाय हाइड्रोजन। अनदर मोनोमर इज स्टायरीन, सो स्टायरीन इज CH double bond CH2 at benzene ring, so this is styrene. Now after polymerization, see there are total 6 carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so first of all you have to write 6 carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and as we know there is benzene ring at the second number of carbon, so you need to draw benzene ring at the carbon number second. Okay, then remaining valences of carbon are satisfied by hydrogen, so you need to draw hydrogen to satisfy the valences. Okay, so this is butadiene styrene copolymer. It is ultimately known as Buna S, butadiene styrene copolymer. Okay, now what are the properties of copolymers? For example, butadiene styrene copolymer is quite tough. So let's see properties of copolymers. So they are quite tough. Okay, then it is a good substitute for natural rubber. Buna S or copolymers are used as a substitute for natural rubber. Okay, then because it is used for the substitution of natural rubber, it is used for the manufacture of auto tires. Because they are tough, they can be used for preparation of auto tires, floor tiles, footwear, and cable insulation. So these are the properties and uses of copolymers. So their main properties, they are tough, and because of that they are main substitute. It means we can use copolymers instead of natural rubber. Okay, and because of this, what are their uses? So their uses are, they are used in the preparation of auto tires. They are also used in the preparation of floor tiles. They can be used in the preparation of footwear, and many a times they are also useful in the manufacture of cable insulation. So these are the properties and use of copolymers. Okay, now we will see another topic. Another topic is natural rubber. Okay, now what is a natural rubber? So as we know, rubber is a natural polymer and possesses elastic properties. So natural rubber possesses elastic property. Okay, it is also termed as elastomer. As they possess elastic property, they are also known as elastomer. We have already seen about elastomers in previous lectures in case of classification of polymers. Okay, and has variety of uses. It is manufactured from rubber latex. So how they are found? They are manufactured from latex. Rubber latex. Okay, rubber latex, which is a colloidal suspension of rubber in water, and the latex is obtained from the bark of rubber tree. It is obtained from bark of rubber tree. Okay, so natural rubber, it has got elastic property. That is why they are known as elastomers. It is found, it is made up from latex, and the latex is obtained from bark of rubber tree. Okay, and the bark of rubber tree, which means latex and rubber tree, is found in various countries like India, Sri Lanka, Indonesia, Malaysia, South America. Okay, the natural rubber may be considered as a linear polymer of isoprene. So natural rubber is made up of isoprene, and here the structure of isoprene. Isoprene is 4 carbon ring and methyl substitution at the second carbon. Okay, so this is ultimately beta 1,3-diene, but in case of beta 1,3-diene at second number carbon, you need to substitute methyl group instead of hydrogen. So this is structure of isoprene. Okay, in short, rubber is made up of isoprene unit. So natural rubber may be considered as a linear polymer of isoprene. Isoprene is a common name. Its IUPAC name will be 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. 3-methyl-1,3-butadiene. So second number carbon is having methyl group, so 2-methyl. First number carbon and third number carbon are having double bond, so beta-1,3-diene or 1,3-butadiene. So isoprene is a monomer of natural rubber. Okay, now if we look at the structure of natural rubber, they are known as cis polypropene. Cis polypropene. So natural rubber is a cis polypropene molecule, consist of various chains held together by weak van der Waals interaction, and has a coiled structure. Okay, now the property of natural rubber is it can be stretched like a spring. Stretchable property. It can be stretched like a spring and exhibits elastic property, which means it has got elastic property. Okay, now if you look at the structure here, it is made up of cis polypropene, which means polypropene molecules are added with each other and it will form natural rubber. So this is polypropene, which means poly means many, propene means CH2 double bond, CH3 means propene structure. So many propene molecules will get attached with each other and it will form polypropene. So this is polypropene. So the cis polypropene molecule consists of various chains held together by weak van der Waals interaction, and it has got coil structure. तो दिस इज नेचुरल रबर। नेचुरल रबर इज इलास्टिक इन नेचर, इट इज़ ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम लेटेक्स, एंड लेटेक्स इज ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम बायोकॉब रबर ट्री। इट इज़ मेड अप ऑफ आइसोप्रीन, आइसोप्रीन इज ऑल्सो नोन एज 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene। इट हैज़ गॉट इलास्टिक प्रॉपर्टी, इट इज स्ट्रेच लाइक स्प्रिंग, एंड इट इज सीज पोलीप्रोपीन। सो पोलीप्रोपीन वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न। ओके, नाउ वी विल लुक एट वल्केनाइजेशन ऑफ रबर। नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज वल्केनाइजेशन, वल्केनाइजेशन ऑफ रबर। ओके, नाउ व्हाट इज वल्केनाइजेशन एंड व्हाई वी डू हैव टू परफॉर्म वल्केनाइजेशन। सो नेचुरल रबर बिकम सॉफ्ट एट हाई टेम्परेचर एंड ब्रिटल एट लो टेम्परेचर। सो द लिमिटेशन ऑफ नेचुरल रबर इज नेचुरल रबर बिकम्स सॉफ्ट एट हाई टेम्परेचर, एट हाई टेम्परेचर इट बिकम्स सॉफ्ट एंड ब्रिटल एट लो टेम्परेचर। इफ यू लोअर द टेम्परेचर इट विल बिकम ब्रिटल। सो दीज आर द लिमिटेशन ऑफ नेचुरल रबर, इट बिकम्स सॉफ्ट एट हाई टेम्परेचर एंड एट लो टेम्परेचर इट बिकम्स ब्रिटल। And it has got water absorption capacity, water absorption capacity. Okay, so that is why it is soluble in non-polar solvents, soluble in non-polar solvents. Okay. So to improve upon these physical properties, these are the physical properties of natural rubber. It becomes soft at high temperature, it becomes brittle at lower temperature, it has got water absorption property, it is soluble in non-polar solvents. So these are the properties of natural rubber, and to overcome these limitations or properties and to improve these properties, we need to perform vulcanization. Now what is vulcanization? So to improve upon these physical properties, a process of vulcanization is carried out. Vulcanization is addition of something in natural rubber. So we need to add some molecules in natural rubber. We are adding some molecules or some additive in natural rubber at temperature 373 Kelvin to 415 Kelvin. Okay, so if we are adding something in natural rubber, it is known as vulcanization, and the main additive is sulfur. We are mainly adding sulfur in natural rubber. So the vulcanization is appropriate additive at a temperature range 373 to 450 415 Kelvin. The main additive is sulfur and other molecules. So if we are adding sulfur in natural rubber or other additive molecules in natural rubber, this process is known as vulcanization. And why do we have to go for the vulcanization? Because we want to improve the properties of natural rubber. Okay. If you look at the structure of natural rubber, it will look like this. CH2, it will go on like this. We have already added sulfur, so sulfur will be present in the structure like this. Here carbon, CH2, it is chain is continuous, so CH2 will be there, CH3, CH, CH2, chain will continue. Okay, and second structure can be CH, C, CH3, double bond, CH, CH2, chain will continue. sulfur is added. So sulfur can be present like this, CH double bond CH CH2. So sulfur is added, and on vulcanization sulfur forms cross link. Sulfur form cross link at the reactive site in double bond, and thus the rubber gets stiffened. Because of vulcanization sulfur gets added, it is added and it will form cross link, and because of cross link natural rubber gets stiffened, which means it is more stiffer than natural rubber. Okay, what are the uses of vulcanization? So in the manufacture of tire rubber, we are adding 5% sulfur. So 5% sulfur is added if we want to manufacture tire rubber. And the probable structure of vulcanized rubber, as we have already seen, so more sulfur is added, more will be cross-linking and more will be stiffer molecule. Okay, so vulcanization is done by adding sulfur or another additive molecules to prepare rubber which is stiff than natural rubber. And main uses is the preparation of tire rubber, and for the preparation of tire rubber we need to add 5% sulfur. Okay, so this is about vulcanization of rubber. Now we will see synthetic rubber. So the next topic is synthetic rubber. Okay, synthetic rubber is any vulcanizable rubber like polymer which is capable of getting stretched to twice its length, which means it has got stretchable property. You can stretch the rubber twice its length. However, it returns to its original shape and size as soon as the external stretching force is released, which means it has got stretchable property. Okay, the synthetic rubber are either homopolymers or copolymers. So synthetic rubber can be, they can be homopolymer or they can be copolymer. Okay, now we will see preparation of synthetic rubber. So first preparation is preparation of synthetic rubber. The next topic is preparation of synthetic rubber. First preparation is neoprene. Okay, neoprene is also known as polychloroprene. Okay, it is formed by free radical polymerization. Now what is the structure of chloroprene? Okay, so chloroprene is, the structure is 2-chloro-1,3-butadiene. 2-chloro-1,3-butadiene. So butadiene is total 4 carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 1,3-butadiene. So there will be double bond at first carbon and third carbon. 2-chloro, which means there will be chlorine at second number carbon. Now let's fulfill the valency of carbon. So 2 hydrogen will be here, no hydrogen will be here, here 1 hydrogen and here 2 hydrogen. So this is chloroprene, or it is also known as 2-chloro-1,3-butadiene. IUPAC name is 2-chloro-1,3-butadiene. Okay, after polymerization it will form neoprene. So structure of neoprene is CH2 CCl double bond CHCH2. So this is neoprene. सो नियोप्रीन इज फॉर्म फ्रॉम क्लोरोप्रीन, क्लोरोप्रीन इज अल्टीमेटली 2-chloro-1-3-butadiene, आफ्टर पोलीमराइजेशन इट विल फॉर्म नियोप्रीन. ओके, नाउ व्हाट आर द प्रॉपर्टीज एंड यूजेस? इट हैज गॉट रेजिस्टेंट टू वेजिटेबल एंड मिनरल ऑयल. प्रॉपर्टीज एंड यूजेस, मेन प्रॉपर्टी इज इट हैज गॉट रेजिस्टेंट टू वेजिटेबल एंड मिनरल ऑयल. रेजिस्टेंट टू वेजिटेबल एंड मिनरल ऑयल मेन प्रॉपर्टी. एंड यूजेस, इट इज यूज फॉर मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ कन्वेयर बेल्ट. फॉर द मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ कन्वेयर बेल्ट, कन्वेयर बेल्ट एंड गैसकेट्स एंड होसेस. सो दीज आर द प्रॉपर्टीज एंड यूजेस ऑफ नियोप्रीन. रेजिस्टेंट टू वेजिटेबल एंड मिनरल ऑयल. इट इज यूज फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ कन्वेयर बेल्ट, गैसकेट्स एंड होसेस. ओके, नाउ वी विल सी अनदर सिंथेटिक रबर, दैट इज ब्यूना एन. ब्यूना एन सेकेंड सिंथेटिक रबर. ओके, सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट ब्यूना एस इन प्रीवियस सेक्शन. नाउ ब्यूना एन इज ऑब्टेन बाय को पोलीमराइजेशन ऑफ 1,3-butadiene. सो 1,3-butadiene 1,2,3,4 1,3 1,3-butadiene. रिमेनिंग कार्बन विल बी CH2 CH CH CH2. दिस इज 1,3-butadiene प्लस एक्रिलोनाइटाइल. एंड द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एक्रिलोनाइटाइल इज CH2 CH CN. दिस इज एक्रिलोनाइटाइल. एक्रिलोनाइट्राइल आफ्टर को पोलीमराइजेशन इट विल फॉर्म. आफ्टर को पोलीमराइजेशन इट विल फॉर्म ब्यूना एन. एंड द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ब्यूना एन इज देयर आर टोटल 6 carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. तो यू नीड टू ड्रॉ 6 carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. ओके, एंड सी एन ग्रुप इज एट द फर्स्ट कार्बन. सो वी विल राइट सी एन ग्रुप हियर, साइनाइड ग्रुप. ओके, नाउ देयर विल बी डबल बॉन्ड एट कार्बन नंबर 2, 1, 2. सो डबल बॉन्ड विल बी हियर ओनली. नाउ आफ्टर राइटिंग दिस स्ट्रक्चर यू नीड टू सेटिस्फाई वैलेंसीज ऑफ कार्बन. सो सी एच टू विल हियर, सी एच सी एच सी एच टू सी एच टू एंड सी एच. तो दिस इज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ब्यूना एन. दिस इज ब्यूना एन. ओके, नाउ व्हाट आर द प्रॉपर्टीज एंड यूजेस? सो प्रॉपर्टीज properties and uses. Okay, main property is it is resistant to the action of petrol and lubricating oil. Resistant to petrol and lubricating oil. So main property is resistant to petrol and lubricating oil. And what are the uses? It is used in making oil seals. Making main uses are it is used in making oil seals and it is also used in making tank lining. So these are the properties and uses. Okay, the main properties, it is resistant to petrol and lubricating oil. And the uses of ब्यूना एन rubber are it is mainly useful for the preparation of oil seals and they are also used in tank lining. So ब्यूना एन is second type of synthetic rubber. It is made from 1,3-butadiene and acrylonitrile. after copolymerization it will form vinyl and properties and uses are resistant to petrol and lubricating oil. It is also useful for making oil seals and tank lining. So these are the properties and uses of vinyl and rubber. So today we have seen about natural rubber, vulcanization of rubber and synthetic rubber.